My name is Keith Hodson. I am the head director of the American Music Abroad Gold Tour. I've been a director on this tour for 25 years, as well as my wife, who's the band director at Southern Regional High School in Manahawkin. Just a little bit about me. In a previous career, I was a high school band director for 26 years in New Jersey. And the last 8 years, I've been at the University of the Arts in Philadelphia, and I'm a professor of music education. So that's just a little bit about me. Let me make sure this is going around. Okay. So this is going to be a one-hour presentation. I want to go over American Music Abroad, what it is, the company. I want to go over some of the tour experiences and what they're like. I want to get into our specific itinerary and show you where we're going. And I want to go over all the inclusions. And also maybe a few things that are not included. And so you're fully informed and aware to make a decision. And I want to answer all of your questions at the end that are not answered. So what I would recommend you do is just have a piece of paper and a pen. And as we go, if questions come to mind, jot them down so you don't forget them. And then if I don't answer them, we'll all unmute at the end. Okay, so I like to start off the presentation with that collage of photographs, because I took every one of those pictures in the last few years. And when I was taking every one of those pictures, I had over 150 high school kids with me looking at every one of those spots and images. So if that was exciting, that's exactly what the trip looks like. And I can't wait to show you Europe if you decide. Okay, so a little bit of background about American Music Abroad. We have been taking students to Europe for 45 years, and over 40,000 students have gone to Europe with American Music Abroad. These are 20-day group travel experiences. The Gold Tour will actually be in Europe for 20 full days. Our musical ensembles on the Gold Tour is a concert band, concert choir, a string orchestra, and a jazz band. We have 7 concert performances on the tour in 2024. And each one of our evenings on the tour are planned with group activities. Basically, there's a concert every other night on the tour. And the nights that are in between, we have planned group activities, which I'll go over with you. It might be a disco or a bowling night or a Tyrolean folk festival or things like that. We have expertly crafted itineraries, which we're going to go over what our 24 itinerary is. And it's the reason why we have such great successful tours every year is because our itineraries are so well crafted. And we have 11 tours traveling in 2024 with American Music Abroad. I'm talking to you tonight about the Gold Tour. The Gold Tour is made up of 8 different states. Students are going to be coming from over 50 different high schools representing Massachusetts, Connecticut, New York, New Hampshire, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Delaware, and Maryland. I'll get into the specific itinerary, but just to give you an overview of our tour highlights, we're going to Salzburg, Austria, and Prague in the Czech Republic. It's one of my most favorite cities in all of Europe, is the such a quaint old city of Prague. We're going to be spending a lot of time in Italy toward the end of the tour. We're going to be in Milan and Florence and Pisa and Venice. We're going to be in the Tyrolean region of Austria to start our tour. The Tyrolean region is the mountain region that borders Germany on the western side of Austria. The Romantic Road in Germany, that's old Germany. There are 10th century villages that are still standing, all surrounded by walls and moats. And we are going to be spending some time in Dinkelsbühl, and I'll show you that. The Rhine Falls in Switzerland. That's going to be a nice stop as we enter Switzerland and see the falls. We're going to get a chance to see the Swiss and Austrian Alps. We're going to visit numerous famous cathedrals, and our choir will get a chance to sing in many of them. We also go to a concentration camp. One of the things that every one of the AMA tours do is goes to a World War II concentration camp. I think it's one of the best things that we do on our tour. And as I said, we're going to have seven concert performances. Everything I'm going over with you this evening are included on the tour. We call these the inclusions. But in a nutshell, round-trip airfare, European coach transportation, the whole time we're in Europe, all the breakfasts and all the dinners are included every day on the tour. Entrance fees, and we are going in places multiple and having maybe guided walking tours and so forth. Almost every day on the tour, there are things that require fees, and they are all included. And all our tips for escorts and drivers and restaurants and so forth are all included. Basically, the only thing you really need money for on the trip is your lunches. And we'll get to that in a few moments. So the quality, I know you're going to be very impressed with the quality of American music abroad, ranging from the hotels we stay in, staying in four-star hotels, the meals for in the restaurants, the group dinners that we have are all sit-down, multi-course served meals for our dinners. We have coach transportation. I'll talk to you about the Lufthansa coach company. It's an Austrian coach company that we've been using for many, many years because of the high quality. So I like to introduce the tour in four lenses, so to speak. The first one is the musical lens. So, you know, you're musicians, you're all in your school band, choir, orchestra, and now you have an opportunity to go with students just like you. By the way, music kids are the same all over. So when we put music students from over 50 different high schools together to form the band, choir, orchestra, and jazz band, as we said, it's really a wonderful way to do what you love along with 150, by the way, that's how many students are going to be on the Gold Tour, 150 students as we travel and perform in five countries for the 3 weeks. The picture that you're looking at right now is the Gold Tour. That is the way all our concerts look at the end. That's an outdoor venue, by the way, in Austria, in Meierhofen. But the choir always rejoins the band and the strings, and we always end with a combined finale. I think we're doing America the Beautiful there. Here's a few pictures from this past summer. The ones on the right are actually at a lake in Germany. There was a lakeside resort where we did an outdoor concert. A few more pictures. This is one of the places that we are going to be performing. In fact, it'll be our first performance in concert, is that stage there on the left-hand side. That is the Alpenrosen Hall in Westendorf, Austria. The picture on the right and below was our final concert in 2023, where we were doing our combined finale with our choir and our strings and band. And that was in Innsbruck, Austria. The second lens is the travel experiences. Obviously, we're going to be tourists, and we're going to be touring five different countries, lots of different cultures and history. And the way we get around is on this these coach buses called from the Lufthansa coach company. This is a double decker. We usually have four coaches. Some are double deckers, some are singles. I want you to look at this village, though, and I'm going to talk a little bit about this in a few minutes. But this is Dinkelsbühl, Germany, and every one of these homes are original 10th century homes. And I'm going to talk a little bit about this and why they're still standing. Of course, our travel experiences are going to start and conclude with transatlantic flights. We'll talk a little bit more about the flights as well in a few moments. The third lens that I like to talk about are the cultural experiences. When we're traveling through five different countries, the cultures that you're going to experience are going to contrast greatly. We're first going to start in, we'll land in Germany, but we're going right to Austria. And the first part of our tour will be in Austria. Then we're going to the Czech Republic. And then we're going to Germany. And then we're going to Switzerland. And then we're going to Italy. And every one of those are going to provide you lots of different historical and cultural experiences. This picture you're looking at is a Roman Colosseum that's well over 2,000 years old, right? And this is actually in Croatia, so you're not going to see this, but it's an example of the amazing cultural experiences that we have over there. Oh, this is also Dinkelsbühl, Germany. And I'm going to tell you a story about this town and why we're going to go visit there and why it's so special. But it's these children here in this picture that are the reason that they're celebrating. And I'll tell you about that in a few moments. But I just want you to remember this picture, as well as the other one with the 10th century homes. People come from all over the world to visit during a festival called the Kinderzecken. That's what this parade is part of, this week-long festival. And it actually takes place in July when we're going to be there. We're going to be there on the first full day of the Kinderzecken festival. And the fourth lens is the social lens, right? The social experience. When you put 150 high school kids together, it's bound to be a social experience. And we love that. And one of the main reasons I've been doing this for 25 years, and we encourage it. Now, it is also important that we keep the social experiences and all of these four lenses in check. And in balance. That's what makes the trip so successful. I want to point out I would say something about these two students right here. These students are both from South Jersey. The one on the left was from Cherokee High School, and the one on the right was from Point Pleasant Borough High School. And these two girls were going, this goes back almost 15 to 20 years, but they were going with students from both of those schools. But they decided that they didn't want a room with somebody that they knew or from their school. So they decided they were going to just let the computer match them up. And they were roommates, and they found out that they had just met the best person they ever met in their life, and they became best friends. And they're having a picnic lunch on top of a mountain in Westendorf, Austria. Look at that background. And by the way, you're all going to do that too. If you go on this trip, you'll be able to go with your friends to the top of the mountain, have a picnic lunch with the cows, and have lots of fun. So, as I was just talking about the balance, the travel, the musical, the cultural, and the social are four things that we really want to keep in balance. We aim to do that every day on the tour. For example, it wouldn't be fun if it was just all about the music. So, if we were just practicing and performing all the time, that wouldn't be great. In fact, you're going to pay a lot of money to go see Europe. You want to see Europe and do the travel thing and learn about and be educated about the cultural, and of course, have a lot of fun with a lot of friends and make a lot of friends. So you're going to make 150 friends from 8 different states and over 50 different high schools if you go on this trip. Food, as I said, that the dinners and breakfasts are included. The breakfast buffets are going to blow your mind. They are really outrageous. So much fresh, great food. The dinners, as I said, multi-course serve sit-down meals. The lower right-hand picture is an actual dinner in Leipzig, Germany. I think most of those students are from Haddonfield and Southern Regional High School. When we at lunches, I said that the lunches are really the only thing you need money for on the tour. When we are stopping for lunch, usually they're in villages and towns and where we're giving the kids a great European quaint opportunity to explore. I love what I encourage the kids to do is stop at fresh fruit and vegetable markets and get water and explore with their friends and have a great European experience rather than just sitting in a restaurant during that time. It's great to be out and about. Students, by the way, are always in groups of three or more. They're never alone. And in fact, we always want them in groups of three or more. The lower left-hand corner is a chocolate crepe, and that is my wife hovering over the chocolate crepe. You will love all kinds of great food. Oh, and of course, the pizza. Hopefully, this video comes through. This is a dinner in Hungary, and this is just an example of cultural entertainment. I love this is my one of my favorite kinds of cultural entertainment is when we have dinner entertainment, whether it's music or dancing and both and so forth. So here's a little bit of Budapest. That's what 150 people look like at dinner. And that was a great restaurant. Sorry about that. Let's talk about shopping. So obviously souvenir shopping is a lot of fun to do on the tour. I encourage the students to do the collectible thing, you know, something small and inexpensive like pins, patches, stickers, spoons, pens, where you can get something small everywhere you go and just make a collectible thing. That's fun to do. But the German beer steins in old Germany, the with the pewter tops and very ornately decorated. I know in Venice, the theater masks are popular. Well, you'll see souvenir shops everywhere we go. And I should say this about the shopping. With collectible things and small things like T-shirts and that kind of thing that can fit in your suitcase, that's fine. If you buy something like a cuckoo clock in Germany, we don't have room for 150 cuckoo clocks on these buses. So the big things like that, you'd have to send home. And it's easy to do. So if you plan on doing any more expensive or larger souvenir shopping, you're going to send that stuff home. And the shop will do that for you. So let's talk about the itinerary. This is one of my favorite slides. Get ready for my iMovie magic. Ready? We're going to leave the East Coast of the United States from Newark Airport on an evening flight. And we are going to take a 9-hour flight. Cool, huh? And we are going to land the next morning in Munich, Germany. So let's talk about how that happens. So when we, about 8-9 o'clock in the evening are going to be our planned flights from Newark Airport. And once we get up to cruising altitude, they will then service dinner, a late dinner. And then after dinner, they're going to dim the lights and you go to sleep. And then before you know it, they wake you up and serve you breakfast and you land in Munich at 10 o'clock in the morning. That easy. Going over. First part of our itinerary is going to take us from Munich, Germany to Austria and then the Czech Republic. So when we land in Munich, Germany at 10 o'clock in the morning, the first thing we're going to do is go get lunch. So we're going to take about a half hour away from the airport is downtown Munich. And we're going to, this large picture on the right is called the Glockenspiel, very famous building. It's actually an outdoor shopping mall in the front. So this is all blocked off from traffic. In fact, if you look on the pictures on the left, you can see what it looks like across from that building. It's a large expanse of an outdoor shopping mall. So perfect place to take 150 American teenagers just off the plane to go get lunch with each other and do some souvenir shopping and just experience a German city. You are going to be tired. You're going to have just gotten off the plane. And you probably will not know a lot of people or even know their names. So you're going to get with a group of friends and you're going to start to make friends and learn names and go explore. And then after a lunch stop there for a couple hours, we're going to get back on the coaches and we're going to drive east into the mountains and arrive in Austria, in Westendorf, Austria, but before dinner time. So look at that building on the right. Isn't that gorgeous? This is a ski resort in the summer, and I'm sorry, in the winter time. We're here in the summer. It is absolutely gorgeous, surrounded by mountains, 360 degrees around like that. By the way, the flowers on those balconies here on the right, that's one of the places we're staying, one of our hotels. On the left side, it's another one of our hotels. Around the corner is another. We actually are in like 7 or 8 different, what we call pensions. These are family-run hotels. With about 20 or 30 students, we'll go with staff and chaperones to each of these little things, all walking distance in the center of town. You will go on the top of that mountain. That's where you're going to have your picnic lunch. Lower left-hand corner, you see the Alpenhorns. We're going to have a Tyrolean folk festival, and you'll get a chance to see and even probably try the Alpenhorns in Austria. So let me explain. We are going to be in Westendorf for 4 or 5 days because this is where our rehearsals are going to be. So the Gold Tour started something brand new last year, which was unlike the other tours, instead of going to a college for 2.5 days to rehearse and then put on a farewell concert for the parents, we decided to go straight to Europe and do it in Austria. So what you're looking at is us rehearsing the day after we arrived and got there. The choir on the upper left-hand corner was, they actually rehearsed in the church, in that Onion Dome chapel that you just saw on the last slide. That's where the choir rehearsed. This is the Alpenrosenhall with a stage. This is where our concert's going to be. The band rehearsed in there. In the bottom, in the middle, you'll see the jazz band. That's my wife rehearsing the jazz band. They are actually in a discotheque, underground, kind of small, but it was actually a perfect size for the jazz band to rehearse. And on the lower right-hand corner, you can see the strings rehearsing. There is a new music school in this village that has a wonderful music room with beautiful red padded chairs and wooden music stands. And so we will spend a couple days rehearsing here, take a couple day trips. And I also wanted to mention the difference and one of the reasons why we made this change. So at the college, it's kind of like band camp, right? It's like you rehearsed all morning, all afternoon, all night, next day, all morning, all afternoon, all night, had orientation sessions and so forth and meals. But really it was like being at region band or all state band where you had two or more days of solid rehearsals. So over in Europe, the schedule is like you rehearse for the morning and then you have the afternoon free to go up on the mountain and spend some time with the cows. And then we'll have an evening rehearsal. And then at 9 o'clock, you'll have a Tyrolean folk festival. And so the days are kind of broken up. So you're actually having great European experiences mixed in with our rehearsals. And it worked out so great last summer that we're doing it again this summer. Here's a few more pictures of Westendorf. Those are students up on the top of the mountain with a cow. You see the little village in the upper left-hand corner down in the valley, and that's what it looks like surrounding the village. The town band, you see, that is actually the town band, and the music room the strings rehearse in is actually their music room, their band room, so to speak. The gondola is how you get up to the top of the mountain, and this is a view from the top of the mountain down into Westendorf there in the valley. You're going to love it. It'll probably be the most favorite spot on the whole tour. After a couple days, we're going to take a day trip from Westendorf to the top of a glacier, 10,000 feet in the Alps. You see the gondola here when the kids are getting on the gondola. You actually have to take three of these to get to the top of the mountain. So when you get off one and onto another and you do that exchange, there's going to be a large restaurant where you'll have your lunch on the glacier that day. Then you'll have another exchange before you finally get on a third gondola and get to the top at 10,000 feet. So the girls that are taking the selfie there in the middle, there's a plaque right to the left of them that says on a clear day, you can see the Alps of five countries from this spot. And it points in the different directions where you can see the French Alps, the German Alps, the Austrian Alps, the Swiss Alps, and the Italian Alps, all from this spot at Hindertux Glacier in Austria. Isn't that amazing? Think about that. You're literally looking across Europe. After we do our first concert, which, by the way, we're going to live stream. That concert last year was live streamed very successfully with over 500 people tuning into our concert. It'll be live streamed both on Facebook and YouTube. And the next day, we're going to leave Westendorf now and start our tour headed east. And we're going to go head towards Salzburg. But right before we get to Salzburg, we're going to go to the famous salt mines. These pictures were all taken this past year. It was the first time we had ever been there. You have to get on a little train, and it takes you into a mountain. And then you get on these wooden slides. You can see them on the left where you slide down deep into the earth. You have to wear these white suits over your clothing, so to protect your clothes from the salt. And we are treated to demonstrations, as you can see, a little picture of a demonstration where they talk about how they mine the salt using water to get the salt out of the mountain. And then upper right-hand corner, this is the coolest thing for me. You're down under the ground and then you come across a border crossing. So we were in Austria, but this is actually going into Germany underground. There's a border crossing right there. So great spot for a photo op. And we arrive next in Salzburg. Now, what's Salzburg famous for? If we were in person, I'd be quizzing you and finding out what you knew about Salzburg. So first of all, it is where they filmed The Sound of Music. And if you have not seen The Sound of Music, you have homework to do. I want you to have seen The Sound of Music before you come on the tour. So upper right-hand corner is Mirabelle Gardens. For those of you who have seen it, you know, when the kids were learning to sing music, Do Re Mi, and they were skipping around the fountains. These are the Mirabelle Gardens here. And to the back of that are the steps where they literally jumped up and down on the steps when they sang the steps of the scale when they were singing Do Re Mi. Another thing Mozart, and I should also say this, you know, the filming of that music back in the that movie in the 60s taught the world to fall in love with Austria. And it is really one of the most beautiful and quaint countries in the world. This it is also the birthplace of Mozart. So this yellow house right here is Mozart's birth house. You can go in there, you pay a few years. You're going to have a lot of free time the whole day, basically, in Salzburg. You're going to want to go in there maybe and pay a few euro. It's a museum. See the first pianoforte that Mozart played. In the main cathedral, you can see some of the organs that Mozart played as a boy and as a young man. He was also baptized in that main cathedral. So the lower left-hand corner is the old town. This is all no traffic. It's all small shopping streets, a maze of shopping streets. So another great place to take a large group of high school students, give them free time. You can also go up to the castle. There's a little funicular or a lift, and you pay a few euro to go into the castle if you'd like. Or you can explore the town with your friends. And then we're met by local tour guides who will give us a guided walking, a Sound of Music walking tour of Salzburg. So it's great. You're going to be there all day. And it's actually one of my favorite days on the tour is Salzburg. The next day, we're going to visit the World War II concentration camp of Mauthausen. This is a very somber visit. It's we let the kids just go in and explore it on their own. For those of you that have had your U.S. history classes, you know, you learn about fascism and Nazi Germany and World War II and the horrors. But, you know, until you actually visit a concentration camp over there and bear witness to what happened, it's amazing impact. I'm proud to say I've taken over 3,000 kids to a concentration camp, either Dachau or Mauthausen. We know we get back on the buses. There's always silence for a half hour down the road. There's sniffles and tears. The kids have been affected, and it's a very important thing that we do. Okay, when we leave Mauthausen, we're now going to stop on the Czech border. We're just about to cross into the Czech Republic, and we're going to visit Český Krumlov. This is a lunch stop in this beautiful town. No traffic. It's great to take the students are going to let you go into this village and explore your first time in the Czech Republic and maybe using Czech money. Now, I'll say this. We'll talk more about money later, but they do accept the euro in the Czech Republic, even though they have their own currency. And when we get to Switzerland, they have their own currency, but they also accept euro. So euro will get you through the whole trip. But you might want to, you're only going to be here for a couple of days here in Prague. But if you wanted to get a tip pack from the AAA office or something, a small amount of money, it's nice to experience new other currencies. All right, now we're headed north to Prague. In the Czech Republic here, this is the capital. The famous double spire, we call it, the cathedral. This is in the old town square in the center of Prague. You'll have plenty of opportunity the next day to explore with your friends off the square here as you're going to be getting lunch that day. But I want to show you this bridge on the right. This is the Charles Bridge, and this dates back to the Renaissance. So you're looking at like one of the oldest bridges in the world. These statues there's 30 statues of saints lining the Charles Bridge. When we arrive in Prague, it's going to be just before dinner on this day, and we're going to actually, before we even check into a hotel, we're going to go right to the water, to the river, and get on a riverboat, a dinner cruise. And so we're going to have our dinner on a cruise boat as the sun sets. Prague literally is divided by the river, right? So the western side, as we go up and down the river, the sun will be setting behind the western half of the town. And on the eastern side, you'll see getting all lit up in the evening. And it's really, really beautiful. So you'll see that from the river. The next day, you're going to have a guided walking tour of Prague. It'll include Prague Castle here on the left and Prague Cathedral on the right. And the walking tour will conclude down in the old town square in the center here. Again, there's another picture of the Charles Bridge. You're going to love Prague. Love it. And I'm going to stop talking for just a second and play a little video for you. This is American Music Abroad in performance. You'll see pictures of venues, all kinds of venues that we play in. You'll notice that many of them are outside. Some are inside, some are outside. So enjoy. This is a quote from one of our participants this past summer. They said, talking about the music, the venues we performed in were breathtaking, whether it was the echoing melodies in historic cathedrals or the heart-stirring performances against the backdrop of the majestic Alps. There were powerful emotions displayed, evident from the tears and the standing ovations at every concert. It's really a perfect quote. Okay, our itinerary is going to continue into Germany and Switzerland and Italy now. We're going to leave Prague and go into cross into Germany and arrive along the Romantic Road in the town of Dinkelsbühl, Germany, that I mentioned to you before. That is Dinkelsbühl on the left of those homes again, original 10th century homes. I mean, kids, think about that. Do you have any idea how old those are? That's like over 1,000 years old. I'll tell you why they're still standing and why they're so well preserved. On the right, you can see the moat and the wall. Please don't go jump in the moat. But there are paddle boats. You can go paddle boating on the moat. That's a lot of fun. Here's a few more pictures of Dinkelsbühl, a couple at night, and a gorgeous town. The cathedral here in the center, St. George's, and there's a picture inside. It's one of my favorite cathedrals. So let me tell you a quick story. The reason why this town is still standing is because in 1620, when the Swedes came down from the north and they were conquering this area of Germany, the story is that the Swedish army was camped outside the wall and they were getting ready to attack Dinkelsbühl. And then the story goes that the Swedish general saw Dinkelsbühl children that reminded him very much of his own children. And so he decided he was going to spare the town. And so the Swedes did not attack Dinkelsbühl. And so the on the right-hand side, you'll see a little statue that's depicting the Swedish general and Dinkelsbühl children. And so you saw the picture I showed earlier in the slideshow of all the children in the parade. They were celebrating the time, this Kinderzecken is this festival that celebrates the time when the children saved the town. And like I said, we're going to be there for the festival on the very first full day of the festival. And what better way to see old Germany celebrating its history and culture than seeing a festival like that. So you're going to love that. So the next day, we're actually going to take you to another town that looks very much like Dinkelsbühl, but it's much bigger. As you can see, really, really quaint. This is called Rothenburg Obertauber, and great place just to take you to do souvenir shopping and get lunch with your friends and explore Cobblestone Street Village. And we'll be having we're going to be taking our uniforms with us on that day because we're going to be stopping for a concert before returning to Dinkelsbühl for the overnight. Now we're going to travel into Switzerland, beautiful Switzerland. One of the people, a lot of people really rave that it's one of the most beautiful places on the tour. These are the Rhine Falls. This is the border between Germany and Switzerland. In the upper right-hand corner, it's that castle there is on the Swiss side. And I'm going to play, this is a little video. You can go on a boat ride here. The little boat ride will get you closer to the bottom of the falls. That's a lot of fun to go on. And then we're going to continue on into Switzerland. And we're going to continue on to Lucerne. Lucerne is in the lake region. In the upper left-hand corner, this wooden bridge burned down years ago. They rebuilt it. This flower-covered wooden bridge has artwork all hanging along it. What I love about this this town around the lake, and it always strikes me, is the architecture of the churches and the buildings and the castles on the hillside. It's all very uniquely Swiss, which can be very different from what you saw in Germany and what you saw in the Czech Republic and then Austria and what you're going to see in Italy. Very, very much, very different, very contrasting. We're actually going to be staying overnight in Lucerne and our hotel. Let me see if I can go back to that one more time. Yep, our hotel is right near this park on the lower right-hand corner, right on the lake. So we're going to get a chance to go for an evening walk on the lake at night. This lion monument is famous. It is huge. You can't tell by the picture, but it is just gigantic, enormous lion that's carved into the sandstone to commemorate the Swiss Guard. And we'll get a chance to go see that. We're headed south into Italy, and we're headed down to Florence, but it takes a little ways while to get there. So we're going to break up the trip by stopping in Milan, staying overnight, and we'll see the great cathedral in Milan. The next day, we're going to make a lunch stop in Pisa, the famous Leaning Tower. Maybe you can help hold it up like the girl's doing on the lower right-hand corner. And again, it's a lunch stop. You'll have what's such a great place to take some pictures and see the Leaning Tower. And there's also a cathedral you can go into and visit. And then we'll arrive in Florence. And Florence also dates back to the Renaissance. This bridge that you see in the upper right-hand corner is called the Ponte Vecchio. And that also dates back to the Renaissance, that bridge, still standing. Right now, it's lined all with gold stores. So you're probably not going to do too much of your souvenir shopping there, but it's good to go see. It's good to go check out. The cathedral, the Duomo, they call it, on the lower left-hand, is you can't tell by this picture, but it is enormous. All built out of green and rose marble. We're going to be visiting the Academy and seeing the famous statue of David, of Michelangelo. And of course, inside the Duomo, the painting of the dome by Michelangelo. And again, when you see David, you know, you see these in history books, pictures of David, but to see it in person, it is an unbelievable experience. And we're very excited to go back. We haven't been back to Florence in almost 13 years, so I'm really looking forward to it. And the Gold Tour is the only tour going to Florence this year. So that's great night shots. We're going to take you up on a mountain overlooking Florence on one of the evenings that we're there to get some great night pictures. Here's a great picture in the upper right-hand corner inside the Duomo. The famous baptistry on the lower right, famous bronze doors. You'll love Florence, one of my favorite places. We're now headed across Italy to the other side, to Venice. But before we get to Venice, we don't actually stay in Venice. We stay at a spa town about 30, 40 minutes outside of Venice called Abano Terme. And we're going to be giving our final concert in Abano. You're seeing right now a picture of the Gold Tour in concert. And I'd like to just tell you a quick story about this picture, because I remember setting up for this. And this picture is about 20 years old. The chairs were stacked in this is an outdoor piano bar on the right hand side here. The light post you see is like a walkway, a pathway. And they said, you're going to set up and perform your concert here. And we're like, okay, where's the audience going to be? Where we didn't know. So we set up the chairs. And there was no audience there. And we were about to start. This is about like 9:30 at night. And normally the choir would start our concerts. So what we did was the band played a Sousa march for 2.5 minutes. And I kid you not, 200 people were right there when I turned around. And it happened that quick. So then I said to my head choral director, I said, all right, go start the concert. And the choir went out and 300, 400. And then the band played 500, 600. And when the choir rejoined the band, for our finale, we had 20, 30 deep, 700 people surrounding 360 degrees around us. And what we learned was that The Europeans love seeing American kids playing American music. And these Italians, we learned about something about their culture that night. The Italians get dressed up at night in their Sunday best and they go out for a walk late in the evening. That's part of their culture. And so these people were just all out for a walk that night and became our incredible audience. And, something like that would never happen here. So that was an incredible musical and cultural, emotional, musical experience, and that we all learned. Okay, the next day we're going to take you to Venice. This is the end of our tour. If you don't know, Venice is built on 717 islands with like over 450 walk bridges. These are little mini walk bridges that connect all these different islands. There is no traffic in Venice. You got to get there by boat, and then it's a maze of shopping streets. So you're looking in the lower left-hand corner, right-hand corner, I'm sorry, of St. Mark's Cathedral. This is in St. Mark's Square. So we're going to take you all in a big water taxi down the Grand Canal, drop you off here at St. Mark's Square, and then you're going to get lost because this is the way you're going to be in Venice all day. So when you start taking, you go off the square for about a minute, you're going to make a right and a left and a right, and then in this maze of shopping streets, and then you're going to be lost. So what you do is you look on the corner of every building. It says San Marco with an arrow, and you just find your way back to the square, and then you go get lost again. And you're going to do that like six or seven times all day long. Lots of fun. The picture in the middle here is the Bridge of Sighs, one of the most famous photograph spots in all of Venice. The story is that the left side's the court and the right side's the jail. And when people were sentenced, they would be walked across this bridge, and they would look at these out these little windows, and they'd sigh at their last view of Venice. So the story goes. But everybody takes a picture of it. By the way, there's a great picture of two gondolas. You're going to want to go on a gondola ride with your friends. I'll talk about that in a second. By the way, this tower, you want to go up in this tower because the view out that tower, 360 degrees around Venice, is remarkable. You're going to love it. So the largest bridge in Venice is this called the Rialto Bridge. Very famous. You see it in spaghetti boxes or pasta commercials. This is the famous Grand Canal with great restaurants along the Grand Canal. I like eating at this one here a lot. So let's talk about these gondola rides. They used to be you bargain with the gondoliers and try to get a good price. You actually don't have to do that anymore because we found out this past summer they've now set it 80 euro for a half hour, 120 euro for a full hour. I highly recommend you go for the half hour because it's enough and you'll get the everything you need to get out of it. And I think you might be bored if you had an hour ride. I also wouldn't recommend this to be the romantic ride for two. So 80 euros a lot, for a half hour boat ride. So what you do is you get together with five or six of your friends, and then you split the I'm just gonna mute somebody there. You split it. And so for 15 or 20 euro, you get a chance to go on a gondola ride with your friends. The upper left-hand corner is the Doge's Palace. You can go in there and visit that as well. You're going to love Venice. It is a remarkable, very touristy city, but it's very remarkable and worth going. All right, so this is the last full day of our tour, and we're going to come back to Abano for a final banquet. And Venice is going to be a great place to have our final banquet because it's like a seven-course meal. And then we are going to have a meeting because we're going to be getting on flights and coming home the next day and going all our own ways. So we have a lot of details to go over. So after our meeting and we take care of business, we're going to give the kids time to say goodbye to their new 150 friends that you've just spent 3 weeks touring through five countries with and saying your goodbyes. We want to try to get a lot of that out of the system the night before so it's not in our way at the airports the next day. So as a quick snapshot, we land in Munich, we go into Austria to Westendorf. We're going to do our rehearsals and everything there. And then we're going to go to Salzburg and the salt mines, and then into Český Krumlov, up into Prague in the Czech Republic, then cross back into Germany to Dinkelsbühl and down to the Rhine Falls on the border with Switzerland, then into Lucerne, and then down to Milan and Pisa and Florence, and then we're ending our tour in Venice. Okay. That's our staff. By the way, we have a 1-to-10 ratio. So with 150 students on the tour, we are going to have 15 adult chaperones. Those are musical staff. They're all certified public school band, choir, orchestra teachers and spouses. We also travel with 2 registered nurses and 2 school counselors. You're looking at last year's Gold Tour staff. High up on the mountain in Innsbruck, you can look all the way at the top of the picture, the bottom of the mountain there. And here's a few pictures of kids enjoying Europe. Another quote from one of our members this past summer said, "The incredible food, breathtaking views, and amazing people I created bonds with are just some of the reasons I enjoyed this experience as much as I did. I'm a strong believer in traveling, and this trip allowed that passion to grow. Thank you, AMA, for these memories that I will cherish forever." All right, I'm not going to read all this to you, but this is all going to be in an email that you're going to get this evening. If everybody, I'll go over this again at the end, but we did a sign-in. If some people arrive late, there are 2 sign-ins. I did a texting sign-in, which will allow you 60 minutes after the text goes through. You will get a full digital packet in your email with also the link to register for the tour if you decide that that's what you want to do. And that's the only way for you to get that information is to do that text. The other thing that I'm doing is a online Google form for you to fill out that as well, because just in case the text doesn't go through, I want to make sure we can cross-reference and get you that information. So my point is that you will get it within an hour tonight, or if I have to get it your information to the AMA office tomorrow morning, you will then get that email tomorrow morning. So anyway, everything is included here that I've talked about on this trip. The Gold Tour price is $6,199. That's for 3 weeks, 5 countries, and everything that I talked about. The payment plan is broken up from now through May 1st. So when you do a deposit, you pay a $250 deposit, and then December 15th, you pay $500. There's actually nothing due in January, but by February 1st, you make a payment. And then March 1st, a payment, and April 1st, a payment, and then the final balance is due May 1st, okay? By the way, in the brochure that you're going to get in your email, we'll have all the cancellation information included in that digital brochure. Okay, well, let's talk real quickly what's not included. Uniforms. So you saw in many of the pictures, the guys wear gray slacks, black shoes and socks, black belt, white button-down collared shirt. I usually bring the 3 of them for our 7 concerts. Then any kind of red or blue pattern tie and a navy blue blazer. And then the company AMA will send you a patch and a pin that you'll wear on your jacket. And that's it. Everybody looks great. Girls wear navy blue slacks, black or blue closed-toed low-heeled shoes. Why low heels? Because there's a lot of walking, and we are also on cobblestones, and cobblestones and heels don't mix. So you want to go with flats or low heels, and white blouse, and then a flag red blazer. Well, where are you going to get a flag red blazer? You could try Macy's after Christmas, but if you decide to go on this tour, you're going to start receiving newsletters every month or two. There's going to be a newsletter with lots of information and details getting you ready till the time we go in July. And in the newsletters, and these are going to come digitally to your email, both to the participant and the parents will receive the newsletters. And so there will be links to four different companies that we know carry the red blazers, and you can order your blazer online. Okay. If you don't have a passport, you're not going very far. So $120 approximately, you fill out the form, you get your little pictures taken, and you send it in with $120. And it takes about 3 months, 3 or 4 months. So you don't want to wait on that. You definitely don't want to wait till after the holidays. If you can get started on that in the next few weeks before the holiday break, that would be best. As I said, the only thing you really need money for on the trip itself is your lunches. And we'll talk about how much in a minute. Or beverages at evening meals. So here's the way that works. There is always tap water on the table that is free. And one time I was asked, is the water okay to drink? It's better than our water. So you do want to drink it. And you want to drink a lot of it. It's great water. But here's the important thing. It's how we stay healthy on this trip. We drink more water and we get more sleep. And we wash our hands a lot. But if you wanted to get something else at dinner, you want to get a Coke, Sprite, Fanta, iced tea, they would come around with their change purse after the meal and say you owe for two Cokes, and you would pay for other drinks that you get. And the final thing is homebound transportation. So when you get back to Newark Airport on July 21st, you are that's when the tour is over. If you parents want to go drive to Newark to pick you up, that's fine. What we do, I don't recommend it. We have people coming from so far, so many different places. We set up homebound, 5-6 different homebound transportation coaches that will go up to New Hampshire and up to Connecticut and out to Harrisburg and down to Maryland to take people back to a closer location. We have two in New Jersey. Since I know a lot of you are from New Jersey, if you're in middle to South Jersey, there's going to be one going down the New Jersey Turnpike, making a couple stops along the way. Including the last exit in South Jersey before it goes over the bridge to Delaware and Maryland. And one coming down the Garden State Parkway, which already I know will stop at Southern Regional High School off of LBI and down to Mainland Regional near Atlantic City. So there are stops along the way, and we can work out that homebound transportation. All that information will be in the newsletters as we move into the new year. So rooming, if you know you have somebody's going from your school, or you meet somebody from another school that's going and you decide you guys want a room together, you just simply request by March 1st, both roommates have to request each other, and then you'll be roomed together. I would say that only takes, that's about half the tour that does that. Half the tour lets the computer match them up, and that always works out, and you're going to find out you might meet one of the best people you ever met in your life, and you're going to have great 3 weeks of shared experiences with each other. Seating placement. So this is not auditioned. If you would like to go, I know all of your band, choir, and orchestra directors from your schools, and I was in contact with them, which is the only reason why you knew about this meeting. And got a letter to apply. So I will be asking them if they approve you to go, you can go. However, do I put you on first clarinet and give you a solo, or do I put you on third clarinet? So I need to know how you play. And so our staff will evaluate everybody. You're going to send in January a little video, short video, playing a major scale, chromatic scale, two little short little excerpts that you choose. And we'll decide how everybody plays in relation to each other and rank, and then decide who's playing first, second, and third. That's how we do the band and the orchestra. And it also is helpful in the musical staff knowing what music to pick, so that we can pick the appropriate music for the talent level that we have coming on the tour. Okay. All right, real quick, money. $450 survival money. That'll pay for your lunches and small collectible souvenirs, as long as you're budgeting. And we'll teach the kids on the tour about budgeting. And we'll make sure that halfway through the tour, they're really only halfway through their money. Shopping list. There's actually in the newsletter is going to be a shopping list of typical souvenirs that students buy in different countries and approximate prices, so you could figure out how much extra spending money you might want to send. Ways to bring money. Euros. You want to bring euros. And I use TD Bank. They often stock it, but if not, it only takes 2 or 3 days for it to come in. And then every student should have a piece of plastic, a Visa with a PIN. Please do not bring American Express. It's not accepted by most places over there. And also American currency, American cash isn't going to do you much good. So other than the airport at Newark before you leave, that's probably the last time you're going to use American currency. I once had a student who brought, he didn't listen to the instructions, and brought like $1,000 American currency. And his plan was he was just going to go into a bank and like exchange it. Well, that's a good way to lose half your money, because the banks are going to take half of it as a service charge. So please do what I say and bring euros. All right. Every evening is accounted for on this trip. Like I said, concerts of every other evening, disco, bowling type activities, evening walking tours, folkloric entertainment, Tyrolean folk festival. I want to just go over this list of student safety. So there's rules and regulations of American music abroad. Students and parents sign paperwork that say that you agree to abide by the rules and regulations of American music abroad. This isn't open to just anybody. We feel like we're taking only the best kids. And we know that the best kids in the schools are in the music program. So, and we are only going to the schools where we know the music program, know and trust the band, choir, orchestra directors, and we ask them to nominate their students to go. I already told you about the chaperone ratio of 10 to 1 and registered nurses. We also have a tour escort, Jean-Claude Frery from Strasbourg, France, one of my best friends in the world. He has been the escort on the Gold Tour for 36 years, believe it or not. I've gone for 25 years, but he has been doing it even a lot longer. He's a retired phys ed professor from the University of Strasbourg. So we have a three-tiered discipline policy. Really, basically, you screw up, I'm going to yell at you, right? I got to be mom or dad while we're over there for 3 weeks in Europe. If you continue to be a problem or you do something more serious, we are going to make a phone call home and we'll be talking with your parents. I'm going to give the phone to the student and have them, child, I should say, and tell their parents why we're calling home, and we'll have some tears, and then we're not going to have any more problems, right? All right, the third tier. If you do anything illegal, stealing, drugs, you have signed paperwork saying that we have the right to send you home at your parents' expense with an accompanying chaperone at our nearest airport. And I guarantee that a one-way ticket for you and a chaperone home will cost more than the whole tour costs. So we won't have any problems, right? Itinerary. The itinerary is, you will all get a copy of it. Parents will have a copy. It is a hour by hour breakdown, morning, noon, night, everything we are, every place we're going, all our hotels and addresses, phone numbers, fax numbers, everything are all included on the itinerary. My contact number. We are also all in contact by Remind and other apps that we use. I will be texting throughout the days on the tour to the students and so forth. And of course, all the students will have my contact to get in contact with me at any time they need. And bed checks. So the expectation for bed check is that when we do bed checks each night, and they are late, we're getting back late, could be 11, 11:30, midnight. And you're expected to be in your room from bed check to breakfast. And that's my expectation. It really comes down to this. I need to know that you're safe. All right. I'm responsible for 150 high school kids for 3 weeks in Europe. If you are in your room after bed check, then you're safe. If you're out of your room, you're just not safe. You're in a foreign country with foreign locals. You're just not safe. All right. Packing 135-pound suitcase. That's not a lot. How are you going to do it? You're going to read the newsletters, because the newsletters are going to tell you exactly how to pack. 40,000 students have been doing it for 45 years. How many underwear? How many shirts? How many shorts? How many shoes? It'll tell you exactly how to do it. One carry-on. Usually most students bring like a book bag, a 17-pound carry-on. Your instruments, I would just recommend you just list it on your homeowner's insurance. My experience has, in 25 years, I have never had a problem with an instrument. Never lost an instrument, never had a broken instrument. Airlines and the coach companies take care of our equipment. And by the way, we all move the equipment. The instruments are transported in trailers behind the coach buses. And when we set up for a concert, we all all 150 of us bring all the equipment to the concert site. We set up, and then we tear down and we repack after the concert, and we get that down to a science and a pretty efficient, in a very efficient manner. All right, I want you to think about this. So laundry, do you think we take 150 high school kids into a German laundromat with funny money and instructions in German? No, that's not going to work. So what are you going to do? You are going to bring a little bottle of laundry detergent. And when I tell you, you're going to fill your sinks with hot water and you're going to wash the clothes that your needed items that you need to wash. There'll be one or two times on the tour where that those will be opportune times. Why when I tell you? Because you need to make sure that the clothes dry. So if we're staying, it's going to be on the first night where we're staying multiple nights so that you can make sure that your clothes dry. So think about that. That's a very serious thing, because if you put damp, the last thing you want to do on this trip is put damp clothes into your suitcase under a hot coach on the way to the next country. It'll contaminate everything in your suitcase. You can't wash it out. So it's actually a very serious thing. All students and staff, we really need to manage the laundry thing perfectly, right? All right, I'm not going to read these testimonials to you, but we had a student and a parent and a director this past summer who had. I'll just leave it there for a second, let you read them for yourself. Great testimonials from this summer. Alrighty, and there are, oh, I'd love to share this picture with you. These are my students when I was teaching years ago from Mainland Regional, and those were my students on a gondola ride in Venice. Love that picture. Okay, next steps. You want to consider whether this opportunity is right for you. The credentials needed to apply are going to be in that email that arrives 60 minutes after you did the text sign-in. If you didn't do the text sign-in, I'll give you that code on the last slide here in a moment. You want to make sure you do the text sign-in and answer all six questions. Click on the link and use those credentials to apply, and you make your required deposit and start getting excited about experiencing Europe. Share this trip opportunity with your friends, what you've learned tonight on this call, if they were not able to make it tonight, and I can provide them, they can just fill out the interest form. The QR code that was on the letter that you guys got is the way to do that. And I can get information to people that way. And then brainstorm ways to make and save money. I can tell you that I always have a handful of kids who raise every cent of this tour every year. In fact, I'm thinking about one girl from Carmel, New York. She went twice and raised the money both times all by herself, only by babysitting. So it just goes to show, when you really want to go and you really want to do something, you can do it and make it work. AMA, if you decide to, AMA is actually going to be sending you some follow-up emails in the next couple of days, as long as you did that text sign in. And one of them will give you fundraising opportunities. Some things AMA will be doing along the way to that you can take part in, and then other suggestions of things that people have done in the past. So you can do that. And then, of course, if you don't have a passport, begin that process as soon as possible. And there are always questions. I want to just put up this code first. Here's the code, 24GOKH. You're going to send that. You're going to text it to this number. So if you didn't do the sign in, please do that now. And let's open it up for questions. Please either raise your hand, your digital hand, or you can go ahead and unmute and just jump in, as long as it doesn't get too hectic. There's always questions. Let's hear them.